gun, get your gun, get your gun. Take it on the run, on the run, on the run. Hear them calling you and me, every son of liberty. Hurry right away, no delay, go today. Make your daddy glad to have had such a lad. Tell your sweetheart not to pine, to be proud her boy's in line. Over there, send the word over there. That the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming. The drums rum coming everywhere. So prepare, say a prayer. Send the word to beware. We'll be over, we're coming over. And we won't come back till it's over, over there. Over there, over there. Send the word over there. That the Yanks are coming, the Yanks are coming. The drums rum coming everywhere. So prepare, say a prayer. Send the word to beware.
World War I, also known as the Great War, was a global war originating in Europe that lasted from 1914 to 1918. Over 9 million troops and several million civilians died as a result of the war. The trigger of the war started on June 28, 1914, when a young Serbian nationalist named Gavrilo Princip killed Archduke Franz Ferdinand, prior to the throne of the Austro-Hungarian Empire. The assassination set off a chain of events that would later lead to the start of the World War I, barely 1 month later. During this time, the KKK, or the Ku Klux Klan, had expanded to meet war needs. Industry scaled back and jobs became hard to find for returning veterans. The farm economy, in particular, declined. Mixed into these trends were black emigration to the northern states and the expectations of the black veterans returning from the more open society in France. There was, as a result, a great expansion of Klan membership and organization. Klan violence in the south had begun to drive blacks north. Expanding black population in northern cities increased northern interest in the Klan. The experience of blacks in the military, especially among those deployed in Europe, increased black demands for change. Because of the rise of the Ku Klux Klan in the South, the Great Migration occurred. The Great Migration was the relocation of more than 6 million African Americans from the rural South to the cities, up North, Midwest, and West from 1916 to 1917. And this had a huge impact of urban life in the United States. Between July 1st and November 1st, 1916, near the Somme River in France, it was also one of the bloodiest military battles in history. On the first day alone, the British suffered more than 57,000 casualties, and by the end of the campaign, the Allies and the Central Powers would lose more than 1.5 million men. During this time, the Battle of Verdun was about to happen. The Battle of Verdun was the longest single battle of the World War I. The casualties from Verdun and the impact the battle had on the French army was a primary reason for the British starting the Battle of the Somme in July 1916, in an effort to take German pressure off the French at Verdun.
During this time, the mutiny of African American soldiers in the 3rd Battalion of All Black 24th United States Infantry, also known as the Houston Race Riot of 1917, would result in the death of 4 soldiers, 4 policemen, and 12 civilians on this day 25 years ago. The soldiers clashed with police and other armed civilians who have heard about the mutiny. Throughout the night, the factions fought before the War Department disarmed the men and banished the soldiers back to their original New Mexico training campground. Houston was placed under martial law, and later, the entire 3rd Battalion was sent off to serve in the Philippines. Soldiers from the battalion would face court-martial, with 13 soldiers executed by hanging in December later that year. A second court involved 15 soldiers, with 5 of the group sentenced to death.
On November 7th, 1917, Russia's Bolshevik Revolution took place as forces led by Vladimir Ilyich Lenin overthrew the provisional government of Alexander Kerensky. The provisional government came to the power after the February Revolution resulted in the Russian monarchy being overthrown in March 1917. During this time, France had lost many troops to Germany and they needed reinforcements from America. America offered to help by handing over the people that they never used, which were African American troops. France was thankful and accepted them, unlike America. France did not discriminate troops in the military, so they were not doing labor and work anymore. Soon after this, the Harlem Hellfighters arrived in France, used as stevedores. So they basically unloaded ships and did different kinds of labor. They were never going to fight, but finally got the order to go to France because they were desperately needed troops.
Under the French army, the Harlem Hellfighters would soon enter the trenches in a combative role. May 1918, we see a famous event in the history of the Harlem Hellfighters as Private Henry Johnson and Private Needham Roberts sat in a hole in the ground in the dark on guard duty listening for the enemy. Suddenly, a sniper fired at Johnson, and later he heard someone cutting through the barbed wire with wire cutters. A German patrol of around 25 men started attacking Robert and Johnson. They were both injured. Outnumbered, they threw grenades and fired their rifles at the enemy. Johnson's French rifle jammed with the wrong ammunition, so he resorted by using it as a club on a German soldier who was trying to take Robert prisoner. Johnson bet on with his last resort, a ball knife, used against a German who was trying to kill him. Eventually, they retreated after they realized that there were reinforcements approaching. Reports say that Johnson killed 4 German soldiers before passing out due to 21 wounds. These actions became famous in the press, and Johnson and Roberts received the highest award for bravery. Overall, 369 spent 191 days in combat, longer than any other unit in the war, never lost a foot of ground, and never took a man prisoner. The nickname Hellfighters was given to them from the Germans because of this fact. 200,000 African Americans would serve overseas, with most suffering backbreaking labor and non-combative roles. Where African combative troops were around 40,000, the actions of the Harlem Hellfighters in the First World War would change the African public opinion on African American soldiers and pave the way for future black troops.
On July 1918, Harlem Hellfighters and the troops at the front trenches in their sector are at the receiving end of the Kaiser's full might. And they are only one who can stop them. The Harlem Hellfighters volunteer to be left in the front trenches to make it look like they are somewhere they are not. Soon after this, on July 14th, 1918, the 369th Regiment is left on the front trenches and begin to get bombarded. After the artillery battle, they begin a march to help the French 161 Division without protection from shell fire. They are attacked by explosives and poison gas. It will take a full day to march from their position. They arrived a day later and defeated the Germans. World War I ended at 11 a.m. on the 11th day of the 11th month in 1918. Germany signed the armistice, which is an agreement for peace and no more fighting, that had been prepared by Britain and France. At the start of 1918, Germany was in a strong position and expected to win the war.